I am rummaging through the junk drawer in my father's kitchen, looking for clay, or putty, or caulking. I am 12 years old, and I have an assignment due the following day for earth science. I have to make a working volcano. Most of the time there is no mustard, so I don't know how I'm going to find the ingredients for a working volcano. Even now, years later, the bar for financial security is mustard. And paper towels. If I can afford both mustard and paper towels, I feel I'm doing pretty damn well. But on the night in question, my father has said he can't afford the plaster of Paris I need to make this working volcano, so I'm looking for anything I can use instead. I call it my father's kitchen. It's my father's apartment, really. I live there, I suppose, but it would be more accurate to say that I occupy the back bedroom of the place. I use the bathroom and forage food from the kitchen cupboards and refrigerator, cereal and bread and government cheese and whatever else I can find, but mostly I keep to my room and my father keeps to his, lying on his bed listening to Frank Sinatra albums or watching Tarzan movies. Nobel laureate Amartya Sen tells us that shame lies at the core of poverty. Anyone who grew up poor instinctively knows this to be true. She feels that shame every minute of every day, in the background if she is feeling good, and her face if she is not. The shame I already felt was about to get worse, and it would be ground into my bones forever. When I was 12, I had saved up more money from working in my grandmother's shop. This time I was smart. I came home every afternoon and hid the bills in my books. A few dollars in each book. One day when I came home, the books were spilled out all over the floor, splayed open, all the money gone. My brother had found it. When I was in my early 20s, I bought a plane ticket to Italy and was waiting for a check to arrive to use as spending money. They sent it to my mother's house, and she convinced a bank teller to cash it. So, when I get money, I spend it quickly. Psychologists tell us that people who grew up in poverty have trouble controlling impulses, especially the impulse to buy. Being poor can have a permanent detrimental effect on your decision-making. If I had left the house with a dollar in my pocket, I would have spent it by the time I got home. This decision-making continued into adulthood. I once paid $600 for a set of Calphalon cookware when I was about to take custody of my baby sister, even though I only made $23,000 a year. My reasoning was that I had to have enough pots and pans to make a complete Thanksgiving dinner at all times. It's something I'm working on, and I'm much better than I used to be, but not too long ago I bought a skirt on credit for £175 because I thought I would look cool in it at readings. A few years ago, a friend of mine, in a well-meaning attempt to understand the impoverished diets of poor people, ate a food stamp diet for a week. On the last day of the diet, he talked about what he had learned and spoke philosophically about his renewed appreciation of healthy food as he prepared to end his restricted diet with his first good meal of the week, homemade vegetable pizza. He thought about what he had learned as he kneaded the pizza dough. He had already sliced the vegetables, and they sat piled high on the cutting board. While he had the best of intentions, what he said made me sad. He had misunderstood. In his week of eating like poor people, he had missed two crucial ingredients, fear and shame. While he was looking forward to breaking his fast that night, poor people don't get to do that. They don't get to look forward to the end of impoverishment, to a good meal. My friend would eat a healthy meal that night, and he had known throughout the week that he could stop whenever he wanted, that all he had to do if he missed healthy food was open his refrigerator. Poor people never know when the next good meal will come. They look in the refrigerator on the 25th and maybe they only have enough food for a couple more meals, but they don't get paid for a week. And vegetables are expensive. Most poor people can't afford them. All of this causes great shame. I am rummaging through the junk drawer in my father's kitchen, looking for clay, or putty, or caulking. I am 12 years old, and I have an assignment due the following day for Earth Science. We vote Democrat, that is, when we vote, because we sometimes have trouble getting to polling stations. That, until recently, America was guided, to its benefit, by middle-class values, that there was an understanding that education was important. Grown up poor can have PTSD, and many don't have the mental bandwidth that other people have for normal life stressors.